This is a look at some of the rainfall totals from across the state from this first round that equaled 2 to close to 5 inches of heavy rainfall. So even a little bit of rainfall with this next wave will lead to some flash flooding concerns. We also have damaging winds, and yes, we do have a tornado threat in effect across the state as well, as there is a tornado watch in effect. First, I want to run you through the radar, and all these boxes indicate thunderstorm warnings in effect, and these storms are moving off to the east northeast at a speed of around 50 miles per hour. This is one tornado warning getting closer to Adams County. There you can see the southwest corner of the state. Now this is still radar indicated at this point. That tornado warning is in effect until 3 p.m. But as these storms move rapidly up to the east northeast, get ready for some changing weather conditions. We're starting to see some sunshine break out around the Des Moines metro area. That's not necessarily a good thing. Again, you can see this line of thunderstorms just to the west of Carroll at this point, moving rapidly off to the east. They are not going to miss us, so we really want you in your safe spot within the next hour to 2 hours. Thunder and lightning breaking out along the western border of the state, producing heavy rainfall. The storm's getting closer to Atlantic at this point, just west of Carroll and near the Spencer community. The big picture is indicating these thunderstorms moving out of Nebraska. And again, this is where the cold front is located, so the winds will be shifting as the winds become more northerly behind it. We are under a moderate risk for strong to severe thunderstorms, and that means we have all the ingredients in place for large dangerous tornadoes, damaging winds, as well as large hail, and again, more heavy rainfall as well. So how can we tell that these ingredients will be intensifying? We use something, this is a look at a computer model that we use as a guide, but this is showing the rotation potential in these communities around 4 o'clock this afternoon. So that would be in the next hour and a half that we're really going to see these thunderstorms fire up, making their way into the metro by 4 or 5 p.m. Of course, that's bad timing. Lots of folks getting home from work or school activities. So we want you to be in your safe spot in between 3 and 6 p.m. here this afternoon, as the weather conditions will be changing rather rapidly. There is now a tornado watch in effect until 9 p.m. and it's considered a particularly dangerous situation. They rarely put those out, but that's just because we have all the ingredients for some very strong to severe thunderstorms to move through. This is what we're anticipating the radar to look like within the half hour, and then the stronger storms getting closer to the highly populated areas around 4 or 5 p.m. And 5 p.m. you can see just over the interstate making their way through eastern Iowa by 5, 6 p.m. and then again moving out by sunset tonight, and all will be calm overnight. This is that tornado watch in effect all across the state until 9 p.m. Again, we don't want any of you to be scared this afternoon. We want you to be smart. We want you to be safe. So if you do have any questions, you can keep it right here. And you can also go to our live streaming, which is located on our website, that will continue to keep you updated as these strong to severe thunderstorms move through. We also have a flood watch in effect through this evening. So even if you don't see a tornado or experience the very strong wind gusts or the large hail, you are going to experience more rainfall, which will quickly change our roadways as well rapidly. We're at 79 degrees. We've been heating up with the breaks in the clouds. Notice it feels like the lower 80s, the dew point right now in the 70s. These are all unfortunately prime ingredients for strong to severe thunderstorms to break out. Many kids getting home from school now getting dismissed early. The winds are out of the southeast, gusting as high as 30 miles per hour. This is a live look at Osceola. You can see those clouds building there in the distance. Notice where it's the warmest right now, right around Ankeny, Creston, Osceola, Knoxville, Oskaloosa area, even Audubon now climbing into the 70s. The dew points will continue to be high until this front passes through. You'll feel a big change by 8, 9, 10 o'clock tonight, but it still looks like the winds will be extremely strong overnight tonight and gradually die down overnight with calmer weather conditions on tap for Wednesday. No storms, no rainfall on Wednesday. Most of your Thursday looks dry. We are watching for a chance for thunderstorms on Friday and again Saturday into Sunday, but those chances are starting to go down. It does look like we could see a little rain on Memorial Day. In the meantime, keep it right here to WHO 13. We'll continue to track these storms.